Welcome at video number 58 of the EEP10 model railway simulator. In this video we are going to have a second look at the Märklin layout number 68, as can be found on the Märklin website. The link goes with the text in the video. Let's have a look at that layout second. This was the original drawing that was found on the Märklin website. And, well, I thought it a nice idea to build it. I did it in video number 52. There was a first view. But as you could see over there, there were still some problems with the control system, because in the video even, we had a small collision of a few trains. And that kept nagging me, so I tried to solve that, and I built a completely new control system now, using also manual switching combined with complete timer control, so it can also run fully automatic now. Let's have a look at EEP. This is the end result. We have a depot station with four tracks for the westbound traffic. Then a station south for passengers and a small industrial area over here. Then we have a side branch which goes up to station north. And the trains from there have to use the same single track, so the controller must be taking care of that, to again go to station south, and then they can leave again to the depot. There is a second depot for the eastbound traffic, and eastbound traffic is making just a simple round. Well, let's have a look at full screen and go to the control panel. As you can see, we have what I usually do, switches for the every track on every station. So this is the depot west, this is depot east. This is station south with its three tracks over here, and this is station north, which is four tracks over here. What I added to the control system is these four switches that are currently green. I can switch them by shift clicking on them. That means that now this station south is manually controlled. So every train that enters a track, as we will see over here, track 2 will become occupied, which will mean that the middle switch 2 will be lit, and nothing will happen until I release that train manually. Yes, that will happen sort of now. Yes, this track is now occupied, and that means I can release this train manually. Well, this one was already released before I switched this manual control to red, so I cannot control that anymore. But this new train entering on track 3, that will switch direction. It came from station north, and it will now switch its direction to go that way. And as soon as that happens, that will happen in a second now, you will see that this track 3 will be lit. Yes. Oh, and occasionally there is also coming a train on track 1. And then we can also see that track 1 will be lit. When switching to automatic, I can do that now, but then nothing will happen. I also have to release the trains. So let me first release track 3, and then track 2, and then track 1. And from now on, it will be full automatic again. Well, okay, let's have a little look at the depot. Let's go over there and switch cameras. I don't have a hotkey for the depot, so I do that manually. This is where the trains are stocked in the depot. Four tracks for eastbound traffic and four tracks for westbound traffic. And this is the whole control circuit. It is a full makeover compared to the previous one, because the previous one was a little bit too simple. I had to build some extra protections for the single tracks. But all has been tested now, and all is working now. So let's just have a look at a few video positions. This is a full overview where we can see all the traffic, including the control circuit, so we can see exactly what is happening when, which of course only is interesting if you would like to investigate the workings of the control system. That can be a little bit difficult a task to try to figure out how a control system works if someone else has built it. That's I find it quite difficult to follow the logic of somebody else. I even find it difficult to follow my own logic. After a week I don't know how I have been doing this. So it's just for fun to have this overview for testing purposes. Okay, let's have another camera view. Let's just have a little look at a bird's eye from the southeast, and well, just let's look what is happening for a while. There is actually a lot happening all the time. Trains keep running in and out. Let's say every 20 or 30 seconds something will happen. And you can also see the car traffic and the buses that also stop at the bus stations. We even have a small horse garden over here, a fence with five horses that are eating the grass. And well, it's just fun to watch it for a while. At least it was fun to me, because it has been quite a challenge to create the control system that contained no errors. That took a while, but once that is done, then of course you have the pleasure of seeing it all running without any errors. Okay, let's maybe switch to the southwest camera. That is one press of my hotkey. And oh, over here you also see the traffic is halted, and that also of course is automatic with a few sensors. It's just a single track, so that control is only with some sensors. If you would have a double train track, then you would need a control system for that too. Otherwise the fence goes up too soon, probably. Alright, so this is all available for download. The whole EEP file can be downloaded via a link that goes with the text with this video, so you can play with it yourself a bit. Oh, there are also some dynamic cameras. Let me click this train and then hit my hotkey for dynamic camera, and then we will see that it just follows that train. I work with these hotkeys now. That was demonstrated I don't know the number, but a few videos ago I talked about the program AutoHotkey. And I use that a lot now, so even in full screen mode I only have to press one key and then I switch cameras. So that is quite convenient. I have six cameras programmed, so six hotkeys to switch to them in full screen mode without ever switching back to the menu again. So okay, let's go to the control panel overview. One press of the key and there we go. Well, let's have a final minute of watching what happens, just for fun, and then we will close this video. Oh, by the way, maybe I forgot to mention these green red pillars, they control every station separately, so you can decide yourself which stations you want to operate manually and which stations you want to have on a timer, so that you have full control on every station separately. Okay, well, now that We have seen a few minutes of action. I think we can close this video. See you in a next video probably. Bye bye and thanks for watching.